In today's video, I will talk about the best pre-built gaming PCs under $1,500 of October in 2021. If your budget is below $1,000, you can watch my latest video about the best gaming PCs under $1,000 by clicking in the top right of the screen. So in this video, it will be from $1,100 all the way up to $1,500. And if you have a different budget from this, don't worry, because you will have all the links in the description of these PCs, but also gaming PCs that I recommend buying for every budget. So now, let's start. With the first PC and the cheapest one on the list, we have the ABS Challenger Gaming PC. And this one, I think, is one of the greatest deals that you can get right now in the whole market. It has the i5-10400F, which is a great CPU for 1080p gaming, the GTX 1660 Super, which I think is the best budget GPU on the market, 16GB of RAM, and 500GB of SSD. The only downside that I see for this PC is the SSD. Maybe 500 is not enough for you to put your favorite games on this computer, and that's why I recommend you upgrading the storage if you don't feel like 500GB is enough for you. The i5-10400F and the GTX 1660 Super combination, I think it's a great combination for 1080p gaming, and there is no game that you can't run at 1080p ultra settings 60fps average. With that being said, I think this gaming PC is your best bet if you have $1,100. Another positive feature about this gaming PC is that it has a great airflow because of the front mesh panel, and this is something to keep in mind. Also, if you want to play high demanding video games like Red Dead Redemption 2 and Flight Simulator, this one will be capable of running those games. Of course, Flight Simulator is going to be much harder to run, and you are not going to be able to run it at 60fps average, but you will be able to run this game at around 45fps average in recommended settings. So overall, a great gaming PC, and if you want to buy this one as a first gaming PC, it will be more than enough. With the second gaming PC, for just an $89 difference, we have the CyberPower Extreme VR gaming PC. This one has the i5-11600KF, which is better than the i5-10400F, 16GB of RAM, the RTX 3060, 500GB of SSD, 1TB of hard drive, and Windows 11 Home. Now, I feel like the upgrade from the last PC to this one is necessary if you can afford it. You have a better processor, a better GPU, and you get an entry level of ray tracing. Another thing here, you get more storage, you get 1TB of hard drive as well with the 500GB of SSD, so I think storage is enough with 1.5TB of total storage. So I think this gaming PC is really worth the upgrade, because just for $89, you get a better CPU, GPU, and storage. With the RTX 3060, you can start playing games at 1440p, high settings, 60fps average in a lot of games. And also, I want to say that CyberPower PC lately has been doing a great job with gaming PCs. With the next PC, we have one from ABS once again, and this one is the Master Gaming PC. It has the i5-10400F and the RTX 3060 Ti, 16GB of RAM and 500GB of SSD. The price for this PC is $1,350. So this gaming PC is better from the last one because it has a better GPU. So for gaming, you will be getting better results since the RTX 3060 Ti is better than the 3060. Now, do I recommend spending $170 extra for this gaming PC? Of course, that is up to you and up to your budget, but you can't go wrong with any of these two PCs between the CyberPower and this one. So if you want to buy the CyberPower one because you don't want to spend more, that is totally fine. But if you want to spend more, this gaming PC will do the job for you, and you will actually get better results at gaming in 1080p, 1440p, and 4K. With the next one, we have one from HP, and this one is the Pavilion one with the i7-11700, the RTX 3060, 16GB of RAM, 2TB of hard drive, and 256GB of SSD. This one is really similar to the previous one for the same price, but I put it here because you get a better processor, so for multitasking, this gaming PC will be much better, and you also get more storage, 2TB of hard drive and 256GB of SSD, so here you don't need to upgrade anything at all. The only downside for this PC, I would say, is the airflow for the case. It doesn't seem to have a lot of airflow, but other than that, I think it's worth the buy. But if you don't want to buy an HP Pavilion, you can go with the ABS one and it will be totally fine. But if you want to do some more multitasking, this gaming PC will perform better. And the number one gaming PC for this list is another one from ABS, and it's another Master Gaming PC, and it's really similar to the one I've showed you before. It has the i5-10400F, 16GB of RAM and 500GB of SSD, but here you also get the RTX 3060 Ti, a better case with better airflow, So only for that, I would say this gaming PC is better than the other one, and if you want to do the upgrade for 40 bucks, it will make a difference on the gaming PC temperatures. But once again, I recommend you upgrading the storage if you don't feel like 500 gigabytes of SSD is enough. And before ending the video, I wanna say that every gaming PC of this list will run competitive games at more than 144 FPS average in competitive settings. With that being said, you can buy a 144Hz monitor to pair with any of these PCs or even a 240Hz one if you play games like CSGO, Fortnite and Valorant. And if you want to buy a 144Hz monitor and you don't know which one to buy, you can watch my video about the best 144Hz monitors in the market by clicking in the top right of the screen. And if you found this video helpful, please leave a like and subscribe, but most importantly, hit the bell button so you get notified when I upload this type of content. And if you need help, leave a question in the comment section and I will reply as fast as possible. Thank you guys for watching, thank you for the support, and I will see you on the next one.